Welcome back to class. We will start on chapter 8. It deals with social conflict, critical criminology, and restorative justice. Social conflict, defined as the struggle for power in society. Critical criminologists, they see it, who believe that the cause of crime can be linked to economic, social, and political disparity. Now let's talk about contemporary critical criminology. It looks at the economic and social context of crime, connection between social class, crime, and social control. It looks at the role of government in creating a criminogenic environment. It looks at the relationship between personal / group power and shaping of criminal law, prevalence of bias in the justice system, and lastly, relationship between capitalist economy and crime rate. We will talk about Karl Marx, National Defiance Conference. Relationship between law, power, and crime. Origin of critical criminology. Contemporary critical criminology looks at economic competitiveness, widening gap between rich and poor. It also talk about inequality in the justice system. In other words, the rich and the poor, they don't get treated equally when they commit crime. Demystifying domination. Defining crime and justice. Crime is a political concept designed to protect the power and position of the upper classes at the expense of the poor. That's how the critical criminologists define crime. Some critical theorists include violations of human rights due to racism, sexism, and imperialism, as well as other violations of human dignity and physical needs and necessities as crime. Supranational criminology deals with war crimes, crimes against humanity, genocide, and other human rights violations. War here, it deals with street crimes. That's what most poor people commit. Middle class people tend to commit petty white collar crimes, and wealthy people seem to commit mostly white collar crimes. Instrumental versus structural theory. Instrumental theory, under there we look at how criminal law and the criminal justice system are capitalist instrument for controlling the lower class. Under structural theory, we see how criminal laws and the criminal justice system are means of defending and preserving the capitalist system. Causes of crime also deal with surplus value, defined as profits produced by laboring classes that are accrued by business owners. Marginalization, defined as people being thrust outside the economic mainstream. Globalization, that's the creation and maintenance of transnational market, trade to world economy, growing global dominance, which benefits wealthy, increasing vulnerability of indigenous people, non-democratic cooperation, and influence of international financial institutions such as big banks and world banks. International crime expert Louise Shelley looked at the effect of globalization by saying that globalization encourages criminality. Technology and culture also have effect. State organized crime. These are criminal acts committed by government officials, such as illegal domestic surveillance, human rights violations, extraordinary renditions, state corporate crime, and state violence. Crime and social institutions, class bias and racial oppression from cradle to grave. In other words, from the time we were born to the time we die. Educational disparities, dropout, on a day we have dropout factories. And then the last one is race and racism. Let's look at forms of critical criminology. We have left realism. It explains crime as a function of economic inequality, community deprivation, and lack of supportive institutions. Economic disparity can be laid at the feet of crony capitalism. Community-based efforts for crime control, such as preemptive deterrence. What is the relationship between left realism and terrorism? Critical feminist theory. It explains both victimization and criminality among women in terms of gender, inequality, patriarchy, and the exploitation of women under capitalism. Patriarchy and crime. They evade double marginality and powerlessness. Masculinity and crime looks at hegemonic masculinity, and then being victimized, gender, and the justice system. Power control theory deals with critical feminist model, paternalistic families, role exit behaviors, and egalitarian families. Next one is peacemaking criminology. Purpose of criminology, of peacemaking criminology, is to promote a peaceful, just society. They look at punitive crime control strategies as counterproductive. They favor humanistic conflict resolution to prevent and control crime. The concept of restorative justice. It focuses on needs of victims, community, and offenders. It focuses on non-punitive strategies to heal wounds caused by crime. It also looks at reintegrative shaming. What are the process of restoration? It redefines crime as conflict among offenders, victims, and affected constituencies. Restoration program involve what otherwise known as sentencing circle, where you could have a family group conference and reconciliation. And that's the end of chapter 8, ladies and gentlemen.